Now, for troubleshooting purposes, at some point you may have to come down to the point of really determining exactly which ports need to be open and what services need to be available for the different components to be able to talk to each other. We've got this information a couple different places. If you look at the AF User's Guide, you'll find the same illustrations you'll see in your class workbook. Now, let me just explain what we're trying to point out with this illustration here. What we're identifying here are the different components and the different things you may have to open up given a specific firewall in a certain location. So for example, if you look at this scenario A here, for scenario A, we're talking about connections between the AF server and any AF SDK based clients. So we're depicting this in the picture, showing an AF client over here and the AF server right here. So this line that you see right here, this dotted line in blue, indicates that's what we mean by scenario A. Now, if you have, you know, a firewall at this point between the two, then this is where you would go. You would look under scenario A to figure out what ports you're going to need to open up. And likewise, you know, with when it comes to scenario B here, we're talking about if there is a firewall between your active server, Active Directory server, and the AF server. So, if you've got a firewall at this point, you know, you're looking at this scenario B here, that connection between the AF server and Active Directory, then take a look at what's documented in here, and then so on and so forth. For connection C, we're talking about if there's a firewall between SQL Server and the AF server. If that's your scenario, then take a look at scenario C here, etc. So where you would find more information is if you simply look in the AF User's Guide for each of these, A, B, C, and D, you'll find a specific section that describes exactly what ports are available. So if you're at the point at which you're troubleshooting this down to the port level, and also at the service level, you know, are you implementing reverse name lookup at your site because of your configuration or not? If you're trying to determine those types of things, take a look here. If you go to our tech support website and just do a search for AF ports, the very first thing you should find is this knowledge base article, what ports need to remain open. Now, this is a comprehensive article that describes not just for AF, but for all of the different clients. And it describes the services and the ports, etc., in great detail. And as you can see here on our tech support site, you're going to find links to articles that Microsoft has written about opening up ports for SQL Server, etc. If you do have an ongoing problem with connectivity and AF and ports, please don't hesitate to call us on tech support.